Despite facing embarrassments at various international stages for its complicity in nurturing terrorism, Pakistan continues to provide a safe haven to terrorist outfits. Backed by Pakistan Army and its spy agency, the ISI, many of these outfits are based in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. Despite opposition by the locals, Pakistan nurtured these terror outfits to use them as proxies against India.
Nowadays, banned terrorist organizations, they are moving freely. And local authorities, military and local administration, they are giving them full protocol. And those people who doesn't want to be the part of that holy war or so-called jihad in Jammu and Kashmir, they are kidnapped and disappeared by the law enforcement agencies of Pakistan. And people, they are protesting. They are demanding that their loved ones should be produced. They should bring before the courts. If they did anything wrong, they must have right of justice. But unfortunately, Pakistan is not ready to listen to the voices of the Kashmiri.
The political activists from POK allege Pakistan for misleading the Kashmiri youth and forced them to join for jihad against India. Many uneducated and unemployed youth in POK are forced to take guns.
They are the soft target of the terrorist groups and organizations. They go to them, they ask them to join jihad, they give them weapons, training, money, everything. And this is the worst and very unfortunate condition in our areas, that youngsters, those who are unemployed, they are recruited by banned terrorist outfits. And there is another systematically Pakistan introduced new thing. The youngsters are involved in drugs, narcotics, and local administration, they are not taking any actions who sell their selling narcotics, and youngsters are losing their lives and future, everything.
Having been put in the grey list by the Financial Action Task Force, the terror finance watchdog Pakistan today stands on the cusp of attracting global sanctions for its constant support to terrorism. Its principal partners, including China, have also deserted it for its increasingly active role in terrorist activities. If Pakistan government does not rein in those who have been trying to subvert the democratic structure of the country, time is not far when Pakistan will be declared a terror state, followed with a diplomatic and economic isolation from the world.